Hello, I'm Jack. Welcome to my channel, Practical Programming with Dr. Su. In this video series, you will learn everything you need to get started with wgpu graphics programming in Rust. In the last video, we discussed the color map model. In this video, I will explain how to use the color map model to build 3D simple surfaces. Mathematically, a surface draws a y function on a surface for each x and z coordinates in a region of interest. For each x and z value pair, a simple 3D surface can have at most one y value. We can define a simple surface by the y-coordinates of points about a rectangular grid in the xz plane, as shown here. The surface is formed by jointing adjacent points using straight lines. Typically, a surface is formed using a rectangular mesh grid. However, wgpu only provides triangles as the basic units to represent any surface in 3D. In order to represent a surface using traditional quadrilaterals, we need to write our own functions. Here shows a unit grid, which is a quadrilateral with four vertices. P0, P1, P2, and P3. We can divide this quadrilateral into two triangles. P0, P1, P2 is one triangle. P2, P3, and P0 is another triangle, as shown here. In this example, we will create the vertex data, normal vector data, and color map data for this quadrilateral unit cell. Here, we will use the git tool to clone the source code used in the last example, and then make corresponding changes to that source code to build the project used in this video. Now, let's start Visual Studio Code directly from Windows Start menu. Here, click this. This is a Visual Studio Code interface. Now let's start a new terminal window. Now cd into code folder. From this folder, we make a new directory called wgpu14 and cd into it. Now we can clone the source code used in the last video with the command git clone wgpu13. After this command, leave a space and a period. This will place all our source code in the current folder. Run this command. We can check direct. You can see here, the source code is indeed in the current folder. Now we can open this folder from Visual Studio Code, open folder, code, wgpu14. Here contains the source code used in the last video. This video is based on the color map model discussed in the last example. Now we will generate the vertex position, normal, and color map data for a simple 3D surface described by a function y equal to fxz. Here we will use a rectangular or quadrilateral mesh to approximate the 3D surfaces. Now we add a new Rust file called surface data .rs to the src folder. src folder, add a new file called surface data .rs. First, we add a new method to this file. This method is called simple surface points to this file. You can see simple surface points method. Here also including a private function called normalize point. This private normalize point method is used to normalize a 3D point into the region of -1 and 1. This will provide a better view for different 3D surfaces using the same camera. We can also use this scale parameter here to control the default size of the surfaces. The simple surface points method takes mass function, you can see f here is mass function, as an input argument, which describes a 3D simple surface using a mathematical formula. This allows you to import your own function to draw the surfaces. Here, x minima, x maxima, z minima, and z maxima parameters specify the data range, and nx, nz define a 2D grid in the xz plane. These methods also accept the other two additional parameters. One is scale, one is aspect. The scale parameter here is used to define the default size of the surfaces. An aspect parameter is used to set aspect ratio for our 3D surface. The aspect parameter is in the data range of 0 and 1. Inside these methods, we first populate a 2D array with the function. You can see that we have a 2D array using the function fxz on the 2D data grid. And then we normalize the data into the region of -1 and 1 by calling the normalize point methods here. You can see normalize the points. Here, C minima and C maxima. These two parameters is used to add color map. For the y value, you can see we use 1, here's the y direction. So this method returns the points and also C minima and C maxima for a color map. Next, we need to add another new method called simple surface positions to this file here. This function accepts the points nx and nz as input parameters. Here the points argument can be calculated using the simple surface points. Inside these methods, we specify four points, p0, p1, p2, and p3. These four points define a unit grid cell. This unit grid cell can be divided into two triangles. Therefore, here, the position, we add 6 points. First triangle, P0, P1, and P2, this one triangle. Another triangle, this P2, P3, and P0. So we add these 6 vertices to the position variable. So this is define simple surface position because we have these four loops. So we perform the summation over all the unit grids. So we get the positions for our simple surface. Next, we need to add a new method called simple surface normals to calculate the normal vectors for our simple surface. Add a new method here, simple surface normals. Inside this method, we first define four vertices, P0, P1, P2, P3 for our unit cell. And then we use the cross product of the two diagonal vectors, CA, this is one vector, and DB is another vector. Then we perform CA cross DB, and then normalize, we get the normal vector here, CP. Next, we add this normal vector to the normal variable called normals at six vertices of the two triangles. You can see here. Or these six vertices have the same normal vector, CP. You can see CP0, CP1, CP2. The three components, so they have the same normal vector on this unit cell. Finally, we need to add the color map measures here. Simple surface colors. Again, we define the unit cell use P0, P1, P2, P3. And then we calculate the color map for these four vertices. You can see along the y direction, we use P0, 1. P1, 1, this is Y component to define the color map. Finally, we add this color map to these six vertices of two triangles. For first triangle, we use C0, C1, C2. And for second triangle, we use C2, C3, and C0. This way, we add color map data to our simple surface by performing this for loop calculation. I should point out here, there are several ways to improve the performance of our code. One way is to combine the methods for position, normal, and color. Here, combine to one method. So here, we only need a single double for loop instead of three separate for loops. The reason we use three separate methods here is that some applications may not need all these three types of data. The separate or modularized methods let you easily create the only data you need. The other way to improve the code is to use the indexed vertex data. Here, for each unit cell with two triangles, we create the data for six vertices. If we use the index method, we only need to create data for four vertices. So we save two vertices for each unit cell. Here, I will not discuss this approach because our current method is more straightforward. Now we can save this file and close it. Next, from the SRC folder, open the common.rs file. We need to replace its content with the new code. This file is very similar to that used in previous examples for the light model, except that we replace the object color by the is two side field in the light structure here. You can see we remove the color here and add a new variable is two side to this light structure and the light function here is two side. For the vertex structure and vertex function here, we add a new member called a color. You can see here a color. This represents the color map data. We also implement a new method called create vertices. Inside this function, we first create normalized points here and a y range. You can see we called simple surface points from surface data.rs file. We then use these points to create the position and the normal and the color. Finally, we convert this data into a vector of vertex structure format. You can see we convert the data into the vertex structure with including position, normal, and color. As we define the here, you can see 3 point, position, normal, and color, so that we can use it to create our 3D simple surfaces. The state new function here allows you to specify the vertex data here and the light data as input. This means that we can use the same code to create different 3D surfaces by simply changing the data and the parameters. Or the other part of the code is similar to that used in the last examples. To avoid the code duplication, we also convert the content that is usually found in the main function into a new run function here. You can see here contains a window and an event loop. This code is usually found in the main function. Here we convert it into a run function. Now we can save this file and close it. Since creating 3D surfaces in WGPU looks very involved, so I will stop here for today. In next video, I will show you how to use this code to create a simple 3D sync surface. Thank you for watching.